Hello and welcome. We're here with head football coach Harold Nichols of the Presbyterian College Blue Hose. It's Saturday, August 2nd, day one, or at least not day one, but practice number one is in the books. Everyone's checked in, into the dorms, ready to go. How did the first practice go this morning?
Well, you make a good point. This isn't day one for us. We've had a great summer. Our kids have worked really hard in preparation of the first practice, which we were able to get done today. Felt like that there was a lot of enthusiasm, some carryover from the spring, which is always a good thing. Got a chance to see all the freshman players for the first time. And you've heard me say this before, it's kind of like on Christmas morning when you open up the presents, kind of see what you got. So really excited about after the first day. Really like this football team. I think we've got some leadership that's developing on our team. And we're light years ahead of where we've been. I think we're a little more athletic. I think we got some size that I think will come into play this year. So first day went great. Great attitudes, great enthusiasm. We'll count practice number one. The true test is going to be how we transition from day one to day two and so forth and so on throughout the rest of camp. 27 days we've got the Northern Illinois Huskies, and which will pose a huge challenge for us. Mm-hmm. But I think our kids are excited about the opportunities that they'll face here in the fall. And so really excited about the first day, you know, and coaches have done a good job getting us prepared and got a good practice plan together, and kids went out and executed. So we'll take it and we'll count it.
It was funny, we saw that in the first practice this morning about, you know, some of the freshmen kind of didn't know where to go. But I heard a lot of encouragement, a lot of leadership from, a lot of vocal leadership from the guys. You know, it's first day jitters, get them out. You know, I heard a lot of that going on. It sounded pretty good.
Yeah, I think, you know, that's going to be a key to our success this year. Our senior leadership, our veteran leadership on our football team. They've been through an awful lot here as players as far as adversity and having to overcome things, and so I really think that that's going to pay off, and it's going to pay dividends for us. So you know, those freshmen, their heads are kind of swimming right now a little bit, which is fine. Sure. But you can tell that they've got some athleticism, some skills that I think will translate to this level, and it'll just take a little while to develop them. But I'm excited that they're ours, and I'm excited that they're here.
Because it's not just football. I mean, this is entirely new for them. This is college, and you know, they just got here yesterday. So that's great to see and be a part of. Mm-hmm. What about, you know, you mentioned how this has been better. You know, it's always been better every year. But what about the depth of this team? I feel like that's something that's also another strength of this team, and as opposed to maybe some years past.
Well, you make a good point. You know, to the first one. You know, the transition from high school to college for freshmen, that's a big step. It's a big adjustment. The kids are away from home for the first time in their lives. Everything's so much more volume of everything, the academic piece of it, the athletic piece of it. And so it takes a while to transition. A great thing about it is we've had a good number of them here this summer, and they've been able to kind of ease that transition a little bit. To the second point that you made, I think the depth of our football team every year has gotten better. You know, that's what we've tried to do under Dr. Lilly's leadership, under Brian Reese's leadership, has been able to try to improve our program every year, whether it be facilities or some kind of a budgetary item or whatever it may be. And so really thankful to them that they've given us the opportunity to do the things we do with our program. From a depth standpoint, you know, those younger kids coming in, I think, will be able to provide some of that for us. You know, both lines of scrimmage, you know, we've got more and more bodies, more capable bodies of contributing. Really like our skill kids, our quarterback position, our running backs. I mean, we've got some material to work with. And it takes a while to build that depth. You know, that's not something that happens overnight. And through a consistent recruiting process that we've been able to put in place here, you get a chance to recruit to a great school like PC and all the wonderful things that we have to offer academically and the great faculty and staff that we have here. And so for us, it's an easy sell to be able to get those type of players here. And so it's starting to pay some dividends for us.
You mentioned getting better every year with facilities. Tuesday night, you got to see those lights flip on for the first time. First time anybody's seen them flipped on. First of all, how do they look? And second, how does that feel to be able to be here and see that, you know, first time in 24 years we're PC football playing with lights at home?
It looks great. It's a little surreal, to be honest with you, when I went out there. And
nobody's ever seen that.
No, and with Brian Reese, and you know, we took some photographs of it with, and you know, shout out to Musco Lighting and all that they did for that. It's a great, great set of lights, and it'll give us television quality lights. And I think our fans and alumni and the Clinton community and the Lawrence County community will be able to enjoy our facility and our stadium, and to give us some flexibility with our schedule, games, you know, to be able to work through the, some television opportunities and some other events, you know, that happen here in our community and on campus. That facility gets used quite a lot. And then I think, secondly, it's a little surreal for me because I can remember playing night games when I was a player here, and the energy that was on campus. Yeah, right over there in the middle of campus up there in Old Bailey. And we used to have parents' night, parents' weekend, and there would be a night game. So inevitably, you know, you knew you were going to play a couple of night games a year. And, you know, it's just a different feel, a different energy about the building and the stadium and the parking lot and the tailgating area. And, you know, as a player, it kind of gets you juiced up a little bit. And I think our players will feed off of that some. I think it'll be a great atmosphere in our stadium out there. And what a wonderful opportunity for our program. And, you know, so we're really excited about being able to have the ability to play at night here in the fall.
Well, practice one in the books. And like we always say every year, it looked like football. And long way to go, short time to get there. Northern Illinois creeping up. So what's next going forward?
Well, you know, we've got a great schedule planned. You know, we've got the five-day acclimatization period that you go through that the NCAA mandates that you do. But we've got, a really good schedule, a schedule that's good for the players, that allows them to continue to build their conditioning, learn football, and hopefully we can peak at the right time and as you gear up towards a really good Northern Illinois team. But so, you know, it is. We're like Smokey and the Bandit. Long way to go and a short time to get there. That's one of my favorite sayings. But it looked like football. And, you know, I'm excited about our kids' passion and their energy out there on the field. And I think it's going to pay dividends for us here in the fall.
Sounds great. Great time of the year.
Ryan, thank you.
Thank you. For more, log on to GoBlueHose.com.